All right, I know a lot of folks who take those statins, those cholesterol-lowering drugs. You're going to be very interested in the results of a new study of this drug, which is being called a game changer. It reduces the risk of a heart attack or stroke by 20%. What does it all mean? Dr. Michael Lim is the director of cardiology at SSM Health, St. Louis University Hospital, here to talk about it. Good morning to you, doctor.
Good morning.
The drug is called, is it Repatha?
Repatha. Yes, Repatha is a trade name.
Okay, so what does this drug do that the others don't?
Well, this drug reduces bad cholesterol, which is the LDL, L for lousy.
Oh, good. That's a good way to remember it.
Another 60% below the highest tolerated dose of a statin medication that a patient can take. And so this is a highly powerful cholesterol-lowering medication.
Can cholesterol levels go too low, like blood pressure, for instance?
So we've had this debate for years and years and years, and this debate came out when the statins first came out.
Yeah.
Said, oh, there's some really low cholesterols where we might have problems with this new drug, and there's a class of them. They're called PCSK9 inhibitors. These drugs actually lower LDL or bad cholesterol down into the 20s and 30s, which is unheard of.
Oh my.
Really, really low. Now, the good news, to answer your question directly, is we have not seen any signal of safety concerns of LDL or bad cholesterol being that low.
Well, some people who are on statins might be saying, I want to do this, but it's not for everybody. Why?
Well, it's not for everybody. Two reasons. One, from a global standpoint, a lot of things, it's very costly. It's over $1,000 a month for treatment right now.
And this drug needs to be taken for life. And I saw the article. It comes to about $14,000+ a year.
Yeah, so
unbelievable.
Very costly.
Yes.
So, you know, the trick is, well, which people and that type of thing. Well, we're really talking about this study, 27,000 patients. They all had what we call coronary artery disease. They've had heart attacks before. They've had stents. They've had bypass surgery.
These
primary
are the
people who apply. And they reduce their LDL or bad cholesterol another 60%. The first year, about 16% decreased risk of heart attacks or stroke. The second year, total about 33% decrease in heart attacks or stroke.
Wow.
Now, the critics say, oh, given the cost, it's not for everybody, but also there was no difference in how many people lived or died. So it didn't really affect
gotcha.
How long you lived yet. And so they said, well, this isn't for everybody yet. But I think this is a new, exciting treatment for some people who are doing everything right. Everything right, and their bad cholesterols are still too high, and they say, I want to reduce my risk of heart attack as low as possible.
Even more.
I had one, I don't want to have another one.
So realistically, Doc, how soon can we see this, say, in your office where you would be prescribing something like this?
Well, the interesting thing is this drug has been approved for over a year now because it's so powerful in how it lowers it. So as of today, you know, we're still giving it just like we did yesterday and the day before.
Mm-hmm.
The new study shows not only does it decrease the level of the cholesterol, but it decreases the rate of heart attack or stroke. And so that's phenomenal.
Pretty incredible information. Thank you very much, doctor. If you want to learn more about this study, we will have a link for you on our website as well as our Fox 2 News app. And we thank you very much for joining us. Some very important info today.
Thank you.
All right, John, back to you.
All right, thanks so much, Randy. And you know what?
Yes?
This guy drives you to drink.
Who drives you to drink, doctor?